the failure to provide for a mental health budget in this book is to perpetuate the stigma of mental health and to reinforce the widely held view that the government is failing our people in the provision of mental health in our community. Put more simply, Mr. Speaker, the conduct of the government and the failing to heed the criticisms of the Public Health England report is to ignore the cries of the families who have lost young men to suicide. It is to disrespect the memories of those who have died because they have lost hope and didn't have the support for mental health services that they should have had in a modern, progressive society like ours. The failure to provide for a definitive mental health budget fails to heed the warnings of the mental health charities who have day in, day out repeated their concerns about mental health provision. Critically, Mr. Speaker, the budget fails to address the mental health provision deficit in our community. And given the focus that was alluded to by the Honourable Lady in her contribution of the COVID-related mental health issues that have arisen in our community, its absence in the budget book itself is completely, Mr. Speaker, unforgivable.